The Pokémon franchise has a lot of mystery surrounding its lore about the games and the TV shows and the anime, but today we're going to be answering one of the franchise's most pressing questions: is Magmar a duck? Welcome to Geek Ecology, where a wildlife biologist answers the most pressing questions about made-up organisms. Now, I know what you're thinking, how can Magmar be a duck? This thing, like, breathes fire and has long arms and a tail and long legs and lives in active volcanoes, which are all things that, to my knowledge, modern ducks don't do. But let's start off with Magmar's most duck-like quality, its bill. Ducks have wide, somewhat flat bills that allow them to consume a wide variety of food sources, including aquatic vegetation, seeds, insects, and maybe even things like crayfish and fish. Many dabbling ducks will turn upside down in the water column to stick their heads underwater and forage for food. Given that Magmar has a very similar bill, I think this Pokémon is doing something just like dabbling ducks, except in pools of lava. But what would Magmar be feeding on in these environments? Luckily, the Pokémon world has a wide variety of organisms that seem to do just fine living in incredibly hot conditions. Slugma and Magcargo have ridiculously high body temperatures and almost appear to be made out of lava themselves, and are a Pokémon analog to slugs and snails, organisms that largely feed on plants and small invertebrates as well as carrion that often inhabit aquatic or moist environments. We even have fish-like Pokémon capable of swimming through lava with the dark fire type Chiyu, and Moltres supposedly rests in volcanoes in order to heal itself. Put all these Pokémon together and you might have like an active ecosystem occurring in the lava and magma pools throughout the Pokémon world. Maybe extremophile microbes are the basis for these food chains like those found in hydrothermal vents in the ocean. These unicellular organisms can withstand water temperatures up to 400 degrees Celsius, so it's not too far of a stretch in a world where, like, organisms fall from space and any random wildlife can shoot lasers. That these microbes in the Pokémon world can survive the lava temperatures of 1200 degrees Celsius. So maybe Magmar is just one of the well-known predators that can survive in these hostile environments that Pokémon trainers or humans in general would have difficulty exploring. Additionally, Magmar has extravagant head plumage, similar to many duck species, except Magmar just happens to be on fire, and it almost appears that its arms are covered in feathers, or at least something that resembles feathers. Its black legs could represent the scaled and featherless legs of birds, and the ring around its neck is even somewhat reminiscent of various duck species, such as the ringneck duck. However, its ability to spit fire isn't seen in any other modern duck species that I know of. But what if I told you that a different aquatic bird species spits out something just as dangerous for self-defense? This is the fulmar, and may be responsible for the mar part of Magmar's name. Fulmars are seabirds that nest on islands, which is coincidentally the first place in the Pokémon series that you can encounter a Magmar, since you find them on Cinnabar Island. That can produce a combination of stomach oil, wax, and triglycerides that can be sprayed out of their mouth as a defense against predators. This sticky substance is capable of matting down the feathers of predatory birds and could lead to the loss of their ability to fly, which ultimately becomes fatal. However, that's where most of Magmar's bird-like qualities end. Although it does share a similar body plan with a different Gen 1 bird-like Pokémon in Golbat. Both of these Pokémon have long tails, a bipedal stance, duck-like bills, and arms with fingers. And most of these traits are decidedly not duck-like, so what is happening? Instead, Magmar and Golduck might share a common ancestor that was closer to a Pokémon version of a hadrosaur dinosaur. These dinosaurs lived during the Cretaceous period and had duck-like bills, long tails, and some closely related dinosaurs, the iguanodons, even had stiff thumb spikes similar to the fingers of Magmar. Would this place Magmar and Golduck closely phylogenetically to other ornithischian dinosaur Pokémon like Rampardos, instead of being related to bird Pokémon like Ducklet? Let me know what you all think in the comments. This was kind of a short and goofy hypothesis video, but it's been rolling around in my head for a while, so I just kind of had to get it out. So hopefully it was enjoyable or sparked some thought or debate about our weird duck-billed Pokémon. If you want to learn more about bird Pokémon, you can watch this video of mine where I talk about their different beak shapes and what that has to do with their diet. And anyways, thanks for watching and happy researching.